The royal reception rooms at Christiansborg Palace are located on the ground floor and first floor in the northern half of the palace. The rooms are used for official functions of the monarch, such as banquets, state dinners, the New Year's levee, diplomatic accreditations, audiences and meetings of the Council of State. To reach the royal reception rooms, one goes through the Queen's Gate. And through the hall of the halberdiers, you get to the king's stairway. The reception rooms are richly adorned with furniture and works of art rescued from the two earlier palaces, as well as decorations by some of the best Danish artists. The king's stairway gives access to the upper floor called the Bel Etage, where the oval throne room, the Frederiksborg room and the great hall are located. The Great Hall is the largest and most spectacular of the royal reception rooms. The hall is 40 meters long with a ceiling height of 10 meters, and the gallery runs all the way around the room. The ceiling paintings depict subjects from Norse mythology. The walls of the Great Hall are hung with 17 brightly colored tapestries, illustrating Danish history from the Viking Age to the future. These tapestries were a gift to the Queen from a number of Danish firms, organizations, and foundations in celebration of her 50th birthday in 1990. Danish artist Bjørn Nørgaard made the designs from which the tapestries were woven. The weaving itself was carried out in France, and 60 weavers worked for 10 years to complete them. They were mounted in the Great Hall when the Queen celebrated her 60th birthday in 2000. These tapestries replaced a series of 17th century tapestries that were originally made for the Long Hall in Rosenborg Castle in Copenhagen, but which were brought here in 1928 to furnish the new Great Hall. In 2000, after the completion of the new tapestries, the old ones were moved back to their original location in the Long Hall in Rosenborg Castle. The marble floors date from the 17th century and originally came from the Danish Royal Library's first building. The Queen uses the Great Hall for state dinners, banquets, and the New Year levee. The room can hold 400 guests. The chandeliers are made of glass from the famous glassworks on the Italian island of Murano in the Venice Lagoon. The Green Room. The name of this room comes from its green silk wall hangings, but also might refer to the various Danish landscapes that hang above the doors. The birds in these paintings are also associated with green. The mallard, for instance, breeds in marshlands, while the lapwing breeds in meadows. The Danish house painter Alfred Christiansen was working on the third Christiansborg Palace when the royal family learned that he was a talented landscape artist in his spare time. Soon his paintings came to hang in the Green Room. The Dining Hall. The crystal chandeliers were previously used in the Royal Palace in Oslo, Norway, but they were sold when the palace had electric light installed in 1903. The Danish royal household bought three chandeliers. Two of them are now in the Dining Hall, and the third is in Amalienborg Palace in Copenhagen. When Norway celebrated the 100th anniversary of its independence in 2005, the Norwegian royal house had copies made of the original chandeliers. They are used today in the Great Hall in the Royal Palace in Oslo. The Abildgaard Room. There are also more recent paintings in the room. Doors, chairs, and panels are decorated with all sorts of different animals. The artist was Valdemar Andersen, a Danish painter who was known at the beginning of the 20th century for the posters he painted for the Copenhagen Zoo. The Alexander Hall. This hall is named after the frieze on its walls showing Alexander the Great entering Babylon after his conquest of the Persian Empire. The frieze is 35 meters long and is the work of Danish sculptor Bertel Thorvaldsen. He made it in 1812 during his stay in Rome. The frieze was intended for a room in the Quirinal Palace in Rome, but was to be decorated for Napoleon's imminent arrival. Napoleon never saw the frieze, however. The plaster version is still in the Quirinal Palace, which is now the residence of the President of Italy. This version of the frieze was made in marble for the Second Christiansborg Palace. It was badly damaged in the fire of 1884, but was later restored and reused here in the Alexander Hall. The hall is used for small-scale official occasions such as dinners, prize giving, ceremonies and anniversaries, and for special exhibitions. The Queen's Reference Library. The library's decoration was originally financed through a collection on the Danish island of Funen. For that reason, only craftsmen from Funen worked on its interior. The ceiling painting with its seven elegant storks is the work of Johannes Larsen, an artist from Funen. The library is often used by the Prime Minister, who borrows it from the Queen in order to hold lunches or dinners for foreign guests. The Queen's Reference Library belongs to the Danish monarch. The collection was established by Frederick V, but was badly damaged in the fire of 1794. In the second fire in 1884, though, most of the library was saved. The library contains over 90,000 books. About 10,000 of them are kept in these two rooms here at Christiansborg, while the rest are in Amalienborg Palace. The collection consists of the personal book collections of the various monarchs, as well as books acquired especially for the library. The Flora Danica service originally consisted of 1,802 items, and today it is the most numerous dinner service from the 18th century. The great botanical work Flora Danica, about Danish plant life, appeared in Copenhagen in the year 1776-1883. The Flora Danica service was initiated during the reign of King Christian VII, and manufactured at the Royal Porcelain Factory in the year 1776-1802. The service was probably intended as a gift for Catherine the Great of Russia, but it was long in the making and in the end remained in Denmark. The last time Queen Margrethe had the table laid with the Flora Danica service was in 1990, when Queen Ingrid turned 80. The Velvet Room is named after the impressive velvet wall hangings that cover large sections of the 10-meter-high walls. The coat of arms of Denmark is incorporated into the pattern. Above the doors are marble reliefs by Danish artist Johannes Bjerg. The Corner Room. This painting, The Four Generations from 1903, is the work of Danish artist Lauritz Tuxen. Christian IX is seated on the throne. On the king's right stands his son, the future Frederick VIII, and on his left is his grandson, the future Christian X. In front of the king is the little prince who would, in 1947, become Frederick IX, the father of the present queen. The royal reception rooms also include the Fredensborg Hall, with Lauritz Tuxen's painting of King Christian IX and his whole family together at Fredensborg Palace. This painting shows Christian X riding across the former Danish-German border to demonstrate that the province of North Schleswig was now part of Denmark. It was Christian X who inaugurated Christiansborg when the palace was finally completed in 1928. Frederick VIII was the eldest son of Christian IX and therefore the heir to the Danish throne. Since Christian IX lived to the age of 88, however, Frederick was 63 years old before he became king. He only reigned for 6 years before he died, which is why he is known as the Eternal Crown Prince. Although his reign was brief, he nevertheless managed to lay the foundation stone for the third and current Christiansborg Palace in 1907. The throne room is traditionally the most important room in any palace, and it is where the monarch receives guests. The guests are taken through the series of adjacent rooms to reach the throne room. Today, the queen no longer sits on the throne, however, but stands to receive her guests. The ceiling painting is by Danish artist Kirsten Iversen. It depicts the legend of Dannebrog, the Danish national flag, falling from the heavens and turning defeat into victory. This is said to have happened in Estonia in 1219, when King Valdemar the Victorious led a crusade there. The thrones were made for the second Christiansborg Palace and were rescued from the fire in 1884. The smaller throne adorned with lions is for the king, while the larger one flanked by griffins is for the queen. The walls are clad with silk hangings from Lyon in France. The pattern consists of the Danish coat of arms with three lions and nine hearts. The pilasters are made from Greek marble. King Frederick V and his wife, Princess Louise of Great Britain. The tower room takes its name from the fact that it is situated directly below the tower. Christian Borg's tower, 106 meters in height, is the tallest in Copenhagen. The grand piano was a silver wedding present for Christian X and Queen Alexandrine in 1923. Its sides are decorated with miniature paintings and rhymes from a Danish folk ballad called Little Kirsten, which tells a tale of unhappy love. The tapestries were a gift from the city of Aarhus and show scenes from Danish folk ballads. Each is a magical story of transformation. The tapestries were woven between 1925 and 1929 here in the Tower Room by a group of women weavers from Aarhus. And so we made it back to the King's Stairway, where we had the opportunity to capture more video and pictures of the beautiful surroundings.